In this video, we look at debugging tips for troubleshooting service portal configuration issues. Linked time codes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. Let's start with client script debugging options. From the service portal configuration page, we can access the widget editor, select the widget we want to troubleshoot, and access the client script directly. The console log command outputs the requested string object to the browser console. Here in Chrome, the console is accessible from developer tools or use the keyboard shortcut Command Option I. When used in the client controller, this command is native to the browser. When we add the command to the client script and save it, the script runs again, and here's the output. The data JSON command uses the Angular JSON filter to display the content of the data object in an easy-to-read format. Here we've embedded the command in HTML pre-formatted text tags. The debugger command, native to Chrome and Firefox, sets a browser breakpoint, allowing you to step through a script line by line. Here, the script is paused right before rendering the data message. Now let's look at some server script debugging options unique to Service Portal: console log and SP log. Keep in mind that these commands will only work in the server scripts in Service Portal. They will not work in the script includes of other applications. We can use the console log command in the server script like we did in the client script. But in this case, it logs server-side JavaScript objects and strings to the browser console. The SP log command outputs JavaScript objects and strings to a service portal page, but it only produces output if the logged-in user has the SP admin role or is impersonating a user with that role. Now let's look at some normal ServiceNow functions that you can also use in server scripts to troubleshoot Service Portal. The gslog, gswarn, and gserror commands output text to the syslog database table. In our example, we add a gslog and a gswarn command to the server script. Then we refresh the page and enter a value. When we access the syslog database table and view its list of records, we can see the value the user entered as an information entry, as well as a warning that the value was invalid. The gsaddInfo message and gsaddError message functions output a message or an error, respectively, to a ServiceNow page in the browser. gsaddInfo message is similar to the SP log command we just looked at, but it produces output for all logged-in users. Now let's look at context menu tricks that portal administrators can use on a portal page for troubleshooting. Hold down the Control key and click on a widget on a page to open the administrator context menu. From here, you can edit instance widget options, access the widget instance in the page editor, view the page designer, edit widget options, and print widget data into the console. For a peek into a widget's data at the current point in time, you can print its data to the console log. First, open the browser console, then select one of the following from the context menu: Log to Console Scope Data or Log to Console Scope. When we log scope data, we only see the data object that was sent over from the server. Scope, on the other hand, can hold a lot more than just the data object. Any variables created in the client controller that need to be accessed from the HTML template are stored in scope as well. When we select scope, here's the result in the log. Here's another trick you can use on the service portal page. Deactivating or hiding widgets allows you to isolate widgets on a page to troubleshoot issues. Hold down the Control key and click on the widget to open the Administrator Context menu and select Instance Options. If the Active checkbox is available on the form, you can toggle it on and off to hide and show the widget on the page. But notice that the Active checkbox is not in the form in our example. We need to open the form in the platform so that we can manually configure the form layout to include the Active field. When we clear the Active checkbox, save the form, and reload the service portal page, the widget is now hidden. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.